density and vibrations. The active force in the absolute represents the maximum intensity of vibrations. No matter in which these vibrations proceed, while it is the reverse, carbon represents the minimum density of matter. We will see in the absolute the number of passive force designated by number 2. And the matter in which this passive force has a reverse sound is we see to be oxygen 0. The number of the conductor will neutralize the force designated by the number 3, and the matter in which sounds the number will be nitrogen N. In the order of the action of the forces they will stand in succession 1, 2, 3, that is corresponding to the matters carbon, oxygen, nitrogen. The high density of matter in the standard order, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, flows 1, 3, 2, nitrogen, by rotating the number 3, that is to say, by making the number of the neutralizing force, stands by its density of matter 3, carbon, and oxygen, appears as the density of 3. Carbon, oxygen, and nitrogen, together with the matter in reverse order. Hydrogen, stage 2 density is designated by the number 6, plus 1, 2, 3, that is stage 6.
The first triad. C, O, N retain their numbers 1, 2, 3. Carbon is always 1, oxygen is always 2, and nitrogen is always 3. Became more active than oxygen, nitrogen enters as the active principle in the next triad and enters with the density of 2. In other words, nitrogen has a density of 2 and oxygen a density of 3. So that the nodula of the first triad is the conductor of the active force in the next triad, which it enters with the density of 2. If carbon enters with the density of 2, then oxygen and nitrogen must correspond to it in densities, repeating the ratio of densities of the first triad. In the first triad the ratio of densities was 1, 2, 3, in the second triad it should be 2, 4, 6, that is, carbon of the second triad will possess the density of 2, nitrogen, a density of 4, oxygen, a density of 6. Taken together they will give hydrogen, 12H12. The second triad. According to the same plan and order the following triad will be constructed, FA, stop, MI. Carbon, which was nitrogen, in the second triad enters with a density of 4, the nitrogen and oxygen corresponding to it must have a density of 8 and 12, together they will give hydrogen 24H24. The third triad. The next triad MI, RE, NU, by the same plan and order will give hydrogen 48H48. The fourth triad. The triad NU, C, will give hydrogen 96H96. The fifth triad. The triad left, so, FA, hydrogen 192H192. The sixth triad. FA, shock, MI, hydrogen 384H384. The seventh triad. MI, 3, 2, hydrogen 768H768H9.
Thank you.
atmospheres from hydrogen, 62, hydrogen, 3072 are to be found and play a part in the human organism. Prominence all principal and essential points and for not going into unnecessary details until the principal. Yeah. and speaking of music. In order to obtain a correct and permanent connection between the lower and the higher centers, it is necessary to regulate and quicken the work of the lower centers. Moreover, as has been already said, lower centers work in a wrong way, for very often, instead of their own proper function, one or another of them takes upon itself the work of other centers. This considerably reduces the speed of the general work of the machine and makes acceleration of the work of the centers very difficult. Thus, in order to regulate and accelerate the work of the lower centers, the primary object must consist in freeing each center from work foreign and unnatural to it, and in bringing it back to its own work which it can do better than any other center. A great deal of energy is also spent on work which is completely unnecessary and harmful in every respect, such as on the activity of unpleasant emotions, on the expression of unpleasant sensations, on worry, on restlessness, on haste, and on a whole series of automatic actions which are completely useless. As many examples as you like to be found of such unnecessary activity. First of all, there is the constantly moving flow of thoughts in our mind, which we can neither stop nor control, and which takes up an enormous amount of our energy. Secondly, there is the quite unnecessary constant tension of the muscles of our organism.
Poetic inspirations, religious
organisms can be characterized as substances of different flash points, while the organism itself can be compared to a laboratory in which the combustibles of different strengths required by the different centers are prepared from various kinds of raw materials. Unfortunately, however,